Welcome back, peeps. It's a new day. I spent a little bit of time. Let me get past this mountain here. These mountains are becoming a real pain in the butt because... Uh-oh. I was just about to report something, and it might be false. If I live. Oh, it's a tiny unknown object. It's probably not going to be anything special. It might just be wreckage from something. I was just about to say that I spent a couple hours... I wouldn't say a couple of hours. Maybe an hour. Maybe an hour or so updating this craft. I added batteries because without them, I couldn't, my extra engine and stuff were just taxing the system. So I basically smoothed a few things out, added a couple things here and there to, you know, a little more slickness on the top, so to speak, to try to make it. And I just reload the game so it's acting all funky. Well, hell. I was just about to say, I spent the last hour flying around Earth from pole to pole and have not seen a single red thing. Not in the sky, not on the ground, and I was just ready to make a rage quit video saying that I'm done with space engineers for good. Or at least until they fix this shit. Because Earth disappeared, and I had to respawn it, and there are no bases, by the way, so I'm pretty rage quitting about the fact that when I spawned the vanilla Earth back, there's not a single pirate. What's interesting is the Lonesome Drifter is on the surface. That doesn't make any damn sense. He's supposed to be flying around in space. But unless he's 4 kilometers up over there, but dude, this might be an opportunity because I hear, or I read, I should say, that there might be some special loot on that ship. And I'll be damned, he crash landed. Well, hell, I should start recording more often because I was literally saying I'm done because I thought that I wrecked the universe. Because there hasn't been a single spawn. Not a single spawn, and since I started playing yesterday and landed on the Earth, they're pretty much none, gone. So now, as soon as I hit record, there's a red guy, which means the universe is not broken, although this planet is. This is a very unique opportunity for me to get into this ship, because I've tried to capture one of these several times, and they keep blowing up on me. So I think what I'm going to do is... I don't know how I'm going to approach it without it blowing up. That's really the question. I am just amazed to even see a ship on the ground like this. Okay, you can stop sputtering now. I know where I'm at. What the hell? Come on! What the fuck? What the fuck? Okay, apparently I ran into some weird ass Bermuda Triangle where I'm taking every ounce of thrust I have, including my hydrogen booster, extra boosters, just to stay airlifted, and I'm trying to maybe find a way to set down here without crashing, and then just go in on foot. But you can see I'm having a hell of a time. course, this is exactly when it's going to start freezing out, right? Okay, if I face this way, it's not so bad. So weird. This game just makes no sense half the time. Like, why can't I fly without crashing into the ground here? And I'm just literally going to have to go this last kilometer on foot. You see how quickly I started to descend? For no reason? Well, I didn't break anything that time, but... Shit! You know, I thought that I brought with me in my cockpit some hand weapons. There's no way for me to break into that ship without knocking out the sensors from a distance. There's just no way to do it. And I can't hover this thing. So I'm burning hydrogen as we speak. Boy, this is really tough. There's no way I'm going to be able to hover over it long enough to zoom in and take out the sensors. That's what I need to do. Yeah, I'm more likely to just crash again. Full throttle down with every engine I got. It's still not even hovering. And I can't go in on foot because I have no way to take out the sensor. Alrighty. Well, that was pretty. That was just awesome. Just love that. I don't know if I should bother with a third attempt. I mean, what I need to do is do a precise hit on the sensors. And I have to get pretty close to do that. But I also have to be able to stay perfectly still. Is it going to allow me to do that? I'm still dropping. You know, it must be altitude or something. That's got to be what it is. It's got to be that my altitude is... We're up in the mountains, that maybe I'm not putting out enough thrust. Am I staying still? Holy crap, it looks like I am. That's still too far away. Let me see, and now I know he's hostile. Let me see if I can get close enough to make the shot. I'm just holding it together. There's that sensor. Now if I can stop. Ugh, this is so difficult. I'm giving it everything I got, and it's not going anywhere. Ooh. Stop the freeze ups. I was carried on a horseback to corrupt humanity. Go. Don't make me crash again. Look, I'm giving it full throttle with hydrogen and everything. It's just not moving. That's stupid. I'm telling you, this is like the Bermuda Triangle of space engineers. Oh, that's such a hard shot. Yeah, I got that. Don't know if I got the sensor. I don't think I got that sensor. I think I still see blue. That sensor is everything. That sensor will detect me and then set off the explosion. But I'm trying not to destroy any of the inventory. I think I got it. Now if I can land without crashing, that'd be great. Okay, it looks like I do have a little bit of thrust now. I don't know why all of a sudden I'm getting some thrust. Not that way. Not that way. Not that way. Set down gently. Do it. No, please don't do this to me. Fucking shit! Fucking shit. Now it's ready to lock. Well, stop moving, you son of a bitch. I'm done. Look, I can't stop. It's just gonna wreck. There, just park in a fucking snowdrift. I'm never gonna be able to get home in this thing now. And it's still not locking the landing gear. Son of a bitch. Well, it's not super bad, but it's bad enough. Did I at least salvage the engine, or did it roll down the hill, or... Because if I don't think I have enough engines, or enough motors, to fix it, and if I can't fix it, I can't leave. There's nothing better than spending like 90 minutes on fixing a ship and then having it do this to you. Yeah, I got full power. It doesn't make any sense why this is a problem. And why are those thrusters even on? Yeah. guess those are two that were forgotten. Well, it's going to stay there in the snowdrift, and I'm going to go over here and see if this is even worth doing, or if I need to just reset the game and move on. I don't think I can take off. I mean, unless I can salvage something from here, which is possible. Maybe I can salvage some stuff. I'm going to find out if that sensor is gone or not, because it's going to blow up if I didn't get it. No ammo? Kind of weird. Ah! You know what? I saw it blinking, and I'm like, son of a bitch! Alright. Let's try this again. I know as soon as I get within 50 meters, or it might even be less than that, but that sensor is going to put the timer on that bomb. So, the first thing I need to do, besides take the HUD thing off so I can see, is I need to rush in and hack that fucking bomb. So let's see if I can pull this off. Go, gadget, go. Where's the bomb? Where's the bomb? Alright, well, he had some good stuff. I didn't mean to, like... There must have been a second bomb. Third time's a charm, they say. I know where the explosion in the back, or the warhead in the back is. I didn't see a second one. I have no idea where the second one is. Well, it's all gonna be trial and error. Without power, it shouldn't be able to blow up. You know, I still don't see a second warhead. I got that first one for sure. Huh. Alright. See what's on this baby, and I know it's gonna be good. I saw 1,000 platinum, and I saw a bunch of weapons on the ground last time, so there actually might be enough to justify this this damage. Oh, those thrusters are still on. Yeah, I can fix this pretty easy. It's just, I'm not sure if I have the motors. I probably will if I hack that other system apart. Yeah, otherwise, it's pretty much whole. Give me access to the... Of course, I can't get to the connector. Gonna unload. In fact, you know what? I'm gonna unload everything I can so that I can really get in there and chop chop. You know, is there any way I can refill my hydrogen? I probably can, huh? I should be able to. It should be doing it from the cockpit. For some reason, it doesn't. That's the bad thing about 1G environments. They just burn through that hydrogen. Speaking of burning through hydrogen. That's what I've been. Whoa! Don't be going anywhere, buddy. Where the heck's my gear? There. You're not going nowhere now. Well, that's a heck of a steep incline, isn't it? Well, it's locked to the hillside now, so it should be all right. I just got to fly back and forth a million times. That's all. But I know you're eager to see what's in that container, and so am I. Now we don't have to rush. Ooh. I heard that there were legendary weapons in this craft. I just ran across it by accident. I wasn't looking for any spoilers, but because I was looking up the Lonesome Drifter, I'm like, there were like four Lonesome Drifters in my area at once. I go, what are these guys about? So I just did a little Google, and they said, oh yeah, they got what legendary weapons on board. So we got a Reba compact automatic rifle, a full stock shot off shotgun, compact automatic rifle, Mercy Dual, Thumper grenade launcher. I know that. That's actually a pretty cool weapon, and some missiles. That's a pretty good score. That's definitely worth repairing my ship. I probably could have hacked that timer block, and that probably would have taken care of the explosive too. Anything with motors here is going to help me in my adventure, so. It's one of the few times I really need parts. Normally I don't bother chopping these ships apart because, you know, they're just a couple of junky parts that I really don't need. But in this case, it is. Give me those motors. Don't kill me on your way down. This hill must be a lot steeper than I thought. Well, there's a small cargo container that I didn't see. I wonder what that sound block was programmed to do. Well, I don't think there's anything in there. It would have fell on the ground. I didn't mean to kill it, but it's moving and I'm trying to... I have no way to see what's in the sound block now, so I may as well go ahead and kill it. I wonder if it had like a special... just had something to say, you know? Alright, that's it. Everything else is junk. Breaking it up into small enough pieces that when I do my next garbage collection, that the stuff will just disappear. Oh, there was another sensor on the bottom. That's the sensor that must have set off the bomb. I didn't realize there were two sensors. Okay, well, that's all good. And hopefully I have enough motors. Otherwise, I'm in trouble. Now, I don't have any ammo for any of this, so it's not going to do me any good right now to hold it. 100 platinum's nice. That was one of the things I'm a little bit... I can't say I'm low on it, but it's the lowest ingots I have. Like, I think I wanted to have 1,000, and I think I have, like, 700 or something. And actually, some of these missiles, some of the ammo that I'm shooting requires a lot of platinum. So that's a nice little score. Cool. 27 motors. That might be enough. That just might be enough. I could probably carry most of this on me. One time I wish I had. See, in all my other ships, I have it set up so that it takes components with me. But this doesn't actually have a cargo container inside. All it has is this is the connector in the bottom. That's and the cockpit. That's the only storage. And Tim won't detect cockpits. So, you know, and I'm thinking, okay, I really don't need to store stuff in the connector because that's usually the first thing that gets damaged in a fight. So I didn't have any spare supplies on me. This was supposed to be a scouting mission. It wasn't really meant to be a let's go kick some ass mission. So I'm going to fix this up and see if I can fly it out of here. I at least need, let's see, I'm missing, really the big thing is just missing the thrust engine in the back. So yeah, I'll work on this and see if I can take off and get home. The sun should be coming up probably in about 20 minutes or so. So hopefully I'll get to fly home in the daytime. I don't remember which direction I was coming in. I know that I was flying south. So when I leave here, I'll just continue to fly south and hope I'll run into my ship. Okay, probably because I lost so much armor, I was able to take off with the engines that I have. I lost a battery as well. But the damage isn't too bad. I can repair it pretty quickly. I just don't have the materials. I didn't have nearly enough motors. But, you know, I actually took off pretty easily. It didn't take much thrust at all. And maybe it was because I'm 10,000 kilograms lighter, because I was over 100,000. Before, so I think just losing that armor and the battery and some other stuff probably lightened the load a bit. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and return to my southern approach and hope, since I didn't... I always forget to GPS my base when I land. You know, I always think, oh, I'm only gonna be within 50 kilometers, so I don't need to bother, you know. Anyway, that was a great score. I finally found out what was on those ships. And hopefully that won't be a spoiler for anybody. I guess, you know, I gave you enough advance notice that we were going to get into the cargo and see what was in there. So, yeah, the compass mod is so cool for planets because it allows you to pick a direction and stick to it. So no matter what kind of maneuvering you do, you don't get lost. And I should be getting out of range of that grid in a few kilometers, so it stops beeping. The mountains in this area are crazy. I mean, they're like really high and really steep. And I am certainly not pushing speed like I was, but I'll get home. I have a tiny bit of ice left. I'm going to save it for an emergency. I'm not going to burn it to accelerate at this point. I'll just take the slowpoke approach. really interesting are the batteries. The batteries never charge or discharge, and the power time always says 0%, and the reason for that is that they have exactly as much power coming in as going out, so they never charge or they never discharge. It's like, that's the way the power on the ship is so pushed to the limit that it actually needs the batteries. It needs pretty much every bit of juice. And usually once I get up fast enough, I can back off a little bit. That provides a little more juice to the system. I'm actually not using very much power at this point, but it's still, whatever reason, those batteries are kind of weird on this. It's all thin batteries, so I don't know if that's the reason why it's acting that way, or it's just the way I have the ship designed. See, they're actually fully charged. Whoa, what's that? Is that another unknown object? Yes, it is. Boy, getting lucky today. Let's see what that is. These mountains must just be full of crashed ships. It's like Grim Lake or something out here. Roswell. Yeah, so maybe this is like where Roswell would be on Earth. I think New Mexico, that's pretty flat. Certainly wouldn't have all the snow. Watch it be another one of those ships, and I don't know if it'd be worth setting down to loot it, but maybe. It would be nice to have two of all these weapons at another 100 platinum. Guess who it is? It's another Lonesome Drifter. Well, I'm going to pass over him anyway and see. Why is he like way down there? This one might be a little easier to get to, we'll see. But the key is not getting blown up. And maybe I can just go for that timer block. We'll see. Want to see another bug in the game? I just shut my engines off. Look at my altitude. I'm climbing, and my engines are off. I was trying really hard to land, and it wouldn't let me. I'm like, ah! It's like I'm forcing myself down, right? And it will allow me to go down, but as soon as I let off my keys, I start floating up again. It makes no sense. Buggy piece of shit! Okay. Let's do this. Should take care of it. I hope. Yeah, there's nothing in there last time either. I guess without power. Oh, just an alert sound. Let's see, without power. Got both solar panels this time. Well, I mean, coming home with a lot of junk. If you're wondering what these are, I have a mod installed that when you destroy a battery, you get those discharged cells instead of scrap metal. Because really, that's so dumb that you, when you destroy a battery, think about it, you're just destroying the casing. You're not destroying the cells inside. But I don't know, for maybe for some balance reason, you know, it gave you scrap metal. So I didn't like that, so I put, oh crap. Here's another warhead. It just didn't go off because I killed the timer. But yeah, so that way when you have to move a battery or something, you don't wind up losing all that stuff. Because especially earlier in the game, power cells are expensive to make, right? So here we go with everything drifting downhill again. And, you know, they're expensive to make. So I put that in there thinking that'll probably help a little bit. And it's kind of a neat idea, you know, when you kill a battery, you can put those back in the, basically you just disassemble them in an assembler. And they will give you back the materials to build a fresh cell. So it still is a process. It's not like you're getting away scot-free. You still do have to, you know, put them through the assembly process. You can't just turn around and build another battery with it. Okay, let's get our... I knew it was going to be the same loot. It's okay with me. I like having two of everything. Because you never know. Oh, I'm out of stuff. Out of space. Wow, that's a lot of stuff. That's a good thing you have all this cargo area. I do have a connector down there. I'll move some of the scrap and these discharge cells take up a lot of space. Oh, I guess I can't move those through the cockpit. Well, I can move them through my... There. Although I still can't reach underneath there. I can just keep them in my inventory for now, I guess. I guess that's it. Where the heck did it go? To make sure that I get this last radio piece. Just bust it up a little so that when I do the cleanup, anything under 20 blocks large, which all this junk is under 20 blocks large, will just disappear. Excellent. So two big scores on one run that was just out to do a scouting mission. Didn't expect to find anything. Certainly didn't find any bases. I know that for sure. There are no bases here. Just crashed lonesome drifters. Maybe they were brothers. Don't know. Well, I'm going to head home. I think I'm calling it a night. Till next time. Figure I'd share this cool sight. You actually can see four planetoids out there. Really small one over there to the left. Of course, that's the Earth's moon. That's the biggest one that's closest. And I think that's probably Mars out there. And I'm not really sure what that other one to the right is. That might be the alien planet, but I thought the alien planet was a lot smaller than that. But very interesting. And yeah, this is the manually placed Earth, which is why it has no space stations or anything like that. I am heading, I think, towards home. I'm not going to know until I get close enough to spot it on the radar. Interestingly enough, I'm running at full throttle, and I'm not able to hit maximum speed, thanks to the deadly reentry mod, which basically I have too much drag, which is cool. That's a little bit of realism. Again, that should have been in the vanilla game. You shouldn't have to mod it to have air resistance on a planet. But cool nonetheless, because it means I have to basically limping home. It's going to take me longer. So anyway, I thought that was pretty cool sight. Here's another annoying inconsistency with space engineers. In fact, I should just make a video with all the bugs and inconsistencies. That would probably be like 2 hours long. Watch my crosshairs in the middle of the screen and look at the horizon. Now, because this planet is 120 kilometers, of course the horizon's going to change pretty quickly, especially at this speed. Why is my ship not correcting for this? Because gravity is a constant force pulling me down. And as long as I'm propelling forward at less than escape velocity, I shouldn't be climbing. I understand why this is happening is because speeds are based off the velocity of the universe. That's also why when I am holding a steady velocity in a large ship and I try to walk around, I can't unless there's gravity pulling me to the floor, because it's not seeing my relative velocity against the ship, it's comparing my velocity against the velocity of the universe, which is zero. It's just an annoying bug, it's an annoying physics anomaly that drives me crazy with my physics education. I'd like to see realism in this kind of situation, but you know, having to constantly correct for this horizon changing is annoying. And it's not like I can use autopilot, because autopilot will just crash me into the ground or fly me into space. It's actually crap. The autopilot is crap. It was designed to go between two points in space. It's not designed for use on planets. I was kind of amazed it doesn't factor in gravity or the planet. If you have a waypoint that's not line of sight, it will take you line of sight. It'll try to take you line of sight and wreck you into the ground. Now I know there are mods that allow you to make waypoints as you go automatically, and that would be great. I'm actually considering making that so that I don't have to do these manual flights. Like if I go out in one direction, it would automatically make waypoints for me at that altitude. So I can actually tell my autopilot to follow those waypoints on the return course, and it would actually follow the curvature of the planet because that's what my waypoints are set at. I don't know if I want to go through that trouble. Yeah, this is annoying to have to constantly adjust your altitude. And I think that might be... that's probably the other ship that I was raiding. That's probably what's coming up. Making that long journey home. Okay, here we are back at base. I'm gonna repair my ship soon, but what I wanted to do was try out these so-called legendary weapons. Now the model for this is pretty nice. It's like I went into a lot of detail with the firearm. It's pretty nice, and I like the zoom with the scope and the crosshairs in there and everything. So let's see how this thing shoots. You can see that these are blue, just like it would be in like an MMO or something. There's a special color for the legendary status. So this is the Vengeance Compact Automatic Rifle. And I like putting up it against a fully built light armor block just to see the amount of damage it does. So let's see. That's not too bad of a grouping. It's definitely more accurate than a lot of other weapons. certainly taking its time on this light armor block, though. Heck, I just ran out of ammo. Hope that doesn't screw up my other tests. Okay, well, I went through an entire thing of ammo for that, and it didn't break the block, so let's try the, this is the compact automatic rifle Reba. Maybe it's supposed to be rebar. Ah, yeah. Figures, I used the ammo for the other one, so we'll just test these other ones. Now, this is a Renegade full stock sawed off shotgun. And this is with buckshot, not slugs. Boy, that's a heck of a spread. Let's see how close I have to get most of that to fall on the block. Although it did do some damage, you know, as it blew out the base. Well, it's doing a number on it. And probably one of my favorites here, and I've been wondering about this since I saw it in the shop, the Mercy Dual Killer. The Saboteur. Of course, you don't get a lot of zoom in on this since you're holding two handguns, but that's kind of nice. Pretty accurate. They're all hitting within that little area there. As long as you keep mousing it. That's one mouse push. I don't think that'd be enough to take out any creature in this game. But if you wanted some accuracy at a distance, and this seems to be the only one that was able to break the block. Let's see how the grouping is at a further away distance here. Yeah, it gets a little sloppier at distance, obviously. I'm gonna run back and get some more of this ammo. Okay, we're back here at the range. I wanted to also show you guys this really cool energy weapon, so let me start off with that. Again, you know, nice modeling. Really cool sight. Watch what it does. Look how accurate it is. It's like a laser weapon, basically. Not super powerful, but if you can persist long enough, it'll burn a hole through something. Now this would be excellent for taking out, like, you know how I was trying to get into that Lonesome drifter craft and take out the sensors. Now if I would have been able to, say, at 50 meters away or a little over 50 meters away, use this and zoom in, and I could take that just that sensor out. So I might consider carrying this on, because I have two of them. I can actually make more. This wasn't a legendary weapon. This is just something you can make with the mod. But I may carry one of these in each one of my ships just for something that specific. They take ammo overcharge cells. So let's look at now we've already seen this one. This is my kind of standard issue. I don't know what's legendary about it. Maybe it does more damage. I'm not sure. Maybe just a little cooler. It seems about the same as the one I carry. Now this is the legendary, basically like the sniper rifle. This is the Reba, now that I have ammo for it. Way more accurate, and I can understand why I'd want to carry something like this. It's also quiet. See what it takes to take out one of these blocks. Not too bad. Takes a little while, but it's not too bad. Yeah, I could carry one of these too, instead of the energy weapon. I kind of like that. Because although it's not as accurate as the laser weapon, I think it has a better zoom, doesn't it? Or is it about the same? Yeah, it's probably about the same. It seems like it should have a better zoom. You know, being more of a sniper weapon. So I get to take on lots of scrap metal now. One thing I don't like about being on Earth-like planets is this gravity. I really don't like the gravity. Gotten so spoiled on flying around on the cheap, and I'm constantly refilling my hydrogen tanks. Just kind of, so I just filled them before I left, and now they're empty again. Anyway, that's the weapons update. I'm gonna go ahead and fix this ship, and I'm gonna put some weapons in it this time. So if I ever need a rifle or something, I'll have it in the cockpit.